menace de disparition pour que le pétrole devienne Dieu.
The shock came in 1973 when the Arab oil producers quadrupled their prices. It marked a turning point and an end to the heady confidence. For 20 years, they'd lived with little care for tomorrow. But now the days of cheap petrol and the certainty that the West dominated the world was over. It was the beginning of the end of the greatest boom of the century.
When I think of all the good times that I've wasted having good times, when I think of all the good time that's been wasted having good times, when I was drinking I should have been thinking, when I was fighting I could have done the right thing. All of that boozing I was really losing. Good times. Good times.
There's a second chance to see that part of People's Century tomorrow night at 8:05 on BBC Two.
Joined the church. They may have done, of course.
Funny as it seems, Father Brown was only doing what Anglican priests have been doing all century, trying to spread the word to a world where the very idea of a church, even an English one, has become absurd. Yet this century, the Church of England has survived not just indifference, but bombs, riots, scandals, and wars. Its turbulent priests and meddling bishops continue to make headlines, and political leaders of both left and right still look to it for support. Its survival since 1900 is an extraordinary story, and an extraordinarily English one.
At the coronation of Edward VII in 1902, the Church of England appeared to be at the height of its powers. It was a keystone of national life, and there was no doubt in most people's eyes that it wasn't just the established church, it was the church of the establishment. Out in the rural parishes, things had changed little since the days of Jane Austen and Anthony Trollope. But that was exactly the problem. The Church of England was beginning the 20th century, firmly entrenched in the feudal past.
When I went to church in the old days, it was always in frock coat and topper and ebony cane. That was the days when I had respect for the church. But it was always the front pew.
The squire would be sitting at the front and all the toffs, till you got to the work people right at the back pews, right at the back there, as they come down. The scale, so the pews come down the scale.
It's a feudal past you can still glimpse here in Bottisford near Grantham. It's the parish church of the Duke of Rutland, who still sits in the front pew and still appoints the rector.
Jesus is the Lamb of God
But there the similarities between the present incumbent